Goedemiddag, hartelijk welkom terug hier bij Technology for Automotive Online. We zijn toe aan de vierde keynote lezing van vandaag. De laatste, maar de not least. En oh, we're going to switch to English. I'm so sorry that I started in Dutch. Welcome back to the last keynote lecture of today. The last but not least, that fits better. And standing next to me is Johan Potargent. And he is from the company AMS. And he will guide you through their solutions for the automotive industry. He will do that the upcoming 30 minutes. If you have any questions during this time, please contact us via WhatsApp or via YouTube chat, or via email. Then I will ask those questions after the presentation. And for now, of course, I wish you a lot of luck and a lot of fun listening to Johan when he takes you to their solutions of the automotive industry. Good luck, Johan.
Very well. Tom, thanks. Happy to be here in the Netherlands, of course. And as a Belgian guy, popping over just over the border at this moment, I'm going to take you through quite some innovation projects we've been working on during the latest years. And as you see, the company AMS, and you see it already a little bit in the back, we have been setting up automation projects, but most of the time global. At this moment, I must not point out to you, it's hard, it's difficult to travel, it's not so easy to move on in the global world, but okay, let's take you into the next steps of services and projects. AMS has companies in Belgium, the Netherlands, Germany, and we are still occupied, I should say, in Hong Kong and in South Africa. Main activities, and you see them on the board, the main activities for AMS are software services. And then I mean software services where we are working globally on big scale automotive projects. When I say big scale, it means that we do set up software services in companies like Volvo, BMW, Porsche, Mercedes. This kind of companies, they have services in the kind of programming of robot and PLC systems. One big thing, so it means most of the time programming 300, 600 robots within a period of 6 months and then trying to reach quality. Second thing, turnkey automation projects. And I will guide you through some detailed projects later on. Third thing, very important for the future, is factory of the future. Gathering all data, gathering all big data, and working with the big data and using it, how we can get more production, higher production output in the factory. And the last, as most companies do, you all get them together in one thing. It's what we call innovation. And I will show you some new innovation projects as well. Here, for instance, a sample of automotive automation. And when I say automotive automation, it means large-scale projects. As you can see, projects with 384, 420 robots and so on. And the left one is, for instance, a project at Tata India, that's this one. And in the middle, this was BMW China, and the right-hand side, you see a part at Volvo Ghent. So most of the time, these are the projects we are working on. Another one, well-known for you, of course, in the Netherlands, and if you look very well, you see at the right-hand side, you see the video moving, that's this one. It's an installation where we did set up 28 robots at a beautiful factory here in the Netherlands, Friesland Campina, close to Groningen, I must say, and a production output of about 100,000 cheeses a day, completely manufactured by 28 robots. Enormous, beautiful factory, the most innovative I've ever seen, and the best well-organized. I will get back to that later. You see there quite some robots moving, handling cheese. But it was a bigger project where we also had to include the automation of AGV systems and everything coupled to VMS, PMS systems. Good. We go up to the next one. In Germany, we had the luck to buy a company which was coming out of the organization. Quite some people of you might know it's coming out of an old organization called Grenzebach. Grenzebach is a company well known in automotive. And they were the previous big shareholder as well from the company KUKA. What you see up here is everything which has to do with AGV systems, a fully automated line, fully automated. And then I mean, in the future, what you will see in automotive is that you will see less hard or production line automation. You will see a kind of AGV systems popping from cell to cell. And that's what's happening here. Out of that cooperation, and if you look very well at the picture at the left-hand side, that's this picture. Quite some people of you out of the Netherlands should know this tower, because this is a tower from Amsterdam Airport. And at the right-hand side, you see a robot. If you would travel out of Amsterdam Airport, I can guarantee you, quite sure, that you don't lose your luggage as it runs over our system. No. What you see up here is a fully automated robot system handling, collecting the luggage and getting it into the bin. And look very well, this is a very difficult application because the system is continuously calculating how big is the luggage and where can I get it in the bin so that we get a maximum load for each bin. So quite some people will know this area, I think. Then another one, what you will see in the future is gathering products more and more for warehouses. Here you see, for instance, an installation where the system already knows perfect where he has to put down this kind of packages on a bin or on a pallet. And everything is automated, and this can be used in warehousing technology. So in the future, if you would go, for instance, to Albert Heijn or Jumbo or whatsoever, during overnight, we can make all your packages ready. And as they are used in the corridor, everything will be made ready by the robotic systems. The left-hand side was a project in Belgium. And this is used in what we say, you throw all the packages on a robot cell. And this robotic cell is going to handle, knows where he has to place all the carton boxes. So fully automated, stacking, destacking, loading, unloading, with one type of gripper. And look at the complexity of the gripper technology. It's dealing really about that in the future. Don't get me wrong, in automation, robotic systems, fences and everything, you can buy, everyone can buy. But the most complex is the complete every area you have to run about. As we are also been working always global, by working the global company, what you see here is, for instance, that we are also coupled to a Chinese company. A Chinese company means also that we are using gentry technology. And this picture here, when you look very well, you will see in the back quite some CNC drilling milling machines. This kind of drilling milling machines are fully automated by the gentry systems. And in that factory, we are producing 48,000 brake systems a day. So that's for 12,000 cars. Okay, let's come up now to AMS. Where we are today, 2020, 2024. I've told you in the beginning that we still have quite some people here in Belgium and the Netherlands. Together you must count at about 25, and in Germany 40. Our target, our aim, is to double. But I must not tell you that's not so easy to find today enough skilled people. It's not easy to find and local people willing to travel, and of course, not possible today. That's why when you look in the bottom part, the only thing we can do for the future in automation is that we will grow in countries like USA, Portugal, India, Slovakia, and that might be necessary to attract more people. I get back to that later. Out of the innovation, and that's a little bit where it's dealing about this afternoon, we did set up an automation project. And that automation project is what you see at the right-hand side on top. So it's a globally patented system. The robot is going to use an aluminium mold, which is direct heated transfer by the electrical wires. And the robot starts moving. So in the mold, you put quite some powder. By moving, by rotating, and that's what the robot, the yellow one on top, will do now. At that moment, the robotic system is going to heat, is going to distribute the powder in the mold. After distributing the powder in the mold, he goes to a cooling phase. And it means the powder goes from powder form to liquid. And after cooling phase, you will see the part which will come out. This is a box. This is a machine cover used for the company Picanol in Belgium. It's a complete big box out of polymer material. So that's the system where we started with now about 7-8 years ago. But I must say at this moment, this system took a known road, and I will go in detail back to that. Very important, as I've told you, AMS is based on what we call automation dashboards, big data analysis, and that what you see up here. Good. There's a picture I cannot show today. That's why there is a big question mark. But I can tell you it has to do with a fully automated manufacturing of hydrogen tanks. It's a fully set up of a factory, a fully automated factory, where you start from our technology, where you go to testing, where you go to complete assembly, where you go to the winding of the assembly of a complete hydrogen tank. I must not tell you, that's going to be the future. Customer base, that's not so important today for all of you. I think more important for you all is, and that's why we are here, to show you the RoboMold technology. RoboMold technology can be used, and that's very important for all of us, in what we say, everything which has to deal with fuel tanks and battery packs, then everything which has to do with pressured tanks and the winding, mobility, interior, exterior, and everything what has to do with airplane medical. Also here, we will get back to you in detail. Detail, it means when you look at the technology, and this is a kind of mold which we are using. The mold is out of aluminium, and we are using this mold because the spread of the heat is very perfect around. As I've told you, we put in this kind of mold, we put a powder, and then we start heating. This mold is assembled on the robot head. What you see here, this is a big mold used for a hydrogen tank. The hydrogen tank, where you can say this was a mold of 2.2 meters length. Today we even have an inquiry for a hydrogen tank for 4 meters and 6 meters. So what's happening in that market of hydrogen tanks? We are more and more up to new products, bigger products, and we are up to a length of 6 meters which can be used for a boat. The technology we show you here, I can tell you we had about 2 weeks ago a very important meeting as well in Germany, just over the border in Aachen. And when I say in Aachen, we had there the chance to show you the possibilities of the technology very in detail, where obviously the technology is cheaper, better than what most of the people are using today, than the blow molding technology. That's one thing. So we did really a life cycle analysis, cost calculation, and so on. It's very important. I must say to all of you that today this system, we got a lot of inquiries over globally, all over the world, but we also have to take care, and it's a good chance for us as well, because the China market is moving very, very fast in hydrogen. I get back also to that later on. A system we've been setting up in the US, where you can look at a robotized system, and this one I could not get in as a movie because my customer did not allow us to show the products. I can tell you the product which was, it was a big box. It's a big cover box. It's a box from about 2 meters by a meter by a meter. And it's used for the American Army. It's used to get satellite disks and everything into the field. They drop this box out of the plane at a height of 100 meters. They drop them into the field, also with guns and bullets and everything. That's why it was quite secret. And the technology is that the box is not, cannot crack, cannot open, and should get down on the bottom so that people can use the equipment. Recently, we changed the material, and that's why there is a huge challenge also for the Netherlands and for Belgium, because we are, if you look on the European scale, if you look on the global scale, it's very important to know for all of you that we have the biggest chemical competence center in the world. We can count on this one, so Rotterdam, Antwerp, just to Germany. And don't forget, the second biggest is Houston in the US. They are picking up very fast. But the knowledge center is based here, and we should do more with this kind of products. We managed for this kind of product, and that's why I went in deep in this product. We managed to get those boxes shielded. And shielded means like an airplane, which you the stealth airplane, which you cannot see. So when the American Army is dropping all those boxes, you cannot trace them on the radar. So we are with always working with very, very special applications, niche markets, and so on. Other possibilities you see here. And then you come is to where you should go in the future. If we want to reduce, if you want to have a bigger X radius with a car, and if you're going with a bigger X radius of the car, it means you only can achieve that in the future by a lower weight. We have a beautiful Audi, an e-tron, nice car, the most beautiful car I've seen, for instance, but the weight is today 2.8 tons. It means that continuously six or seven guys like me are sitting in that car. So it means a lot of consumption. The future is less weight, and I know this afternoon there is a beautiful presentation as well. I thought here about the University of Eindhoven, where also quite some people are working on the same principle ID. Less weight. Less weight in filters, exhausts, less weight in fuel tanks. That's why this market, where you look at now, it's a very, very important market for the future, because all this kind of excavators, machines, technology, and so on, they are up to less weight into the market. Another possibility with the technology is when you look at this part, for instance, that's a door of a railway system, which can be made, and we call that with kiss-off zones, so it can be made very strong. And very strong means that we are not obliged today to use carbon fiber or glass fiber, because recycling, it's still an issue there. So today, we are up with our technology where this is not necessary. This is a project we are running today. It's a project which is running in India, for your information, where all trucks are still running on gasoline tanks, but they are coming out of aluminium or steel. And the turnover is set now to all these kind of tanks, which are now made out of polymer materials. It's another beautiful case I wanted to show, and I wanted to show all the people, because this is what we've been doing with quite some people also here in the Netherlands, with the organization, also with Light Vehicle 2025. This is a concept, this is an idea of a possible door which could be produced, for instance, for DAF or Volvo. This is a setup where we are willing to work on continuously with the people here as well. And we do hope to be successful in half a year from now and say, guys, this is a complete door made out of the newest technology and materials and a lightweight. And now we should continue. If you look at this door, if you look indeed at this door, you see it's a door without a mirror. and that's the newest door with a camera system and so on. The principle is to get a big door out of one part, and if you see one part, it should be possible to have a reel from bottom to top, and even with a glass panel. This is something I can't show you. Back again, people, where are we up to? Can you imagine, I've told all of you, polymer parts into the future. This is a biopolymer part. And a biopolymer part, it means a complete body of a car, where we are going to make every 30 minutes a hood, a door left, and a door right. And the idea, the principle, is to make it out of biopolymer. The other business is up here, is battery packs. And then the next one is, for instance, a fuel tank. I've told all of you that we are working on mobility. If you work on mobility in the future, how can you reduce weight? How? And even fuel tanks will still be important in the future. Don't get me wrong, by 2030, you might have 10 to 20% hydrogen. You will have 30, 40% battery packs. But in the end, you still have fuel tanks. Okay. Back again to the hydrogen. The hydrogen, what you see here, this is the system which we have been setting up at AMS. And the hydrogen tank manufacturing is in that big mold. I cannot show you all the details because that's difficult because it's also quite some NDAs are on. Yes. Here you see it, that's a bigger liner, a liner of 2.2 meter. As I've told you, we are up now to liners to 4 and 6 meters. New things we are going to set up, it means that new materials, back again, a challenge for local companies, local people, local and so on, together and to see how we come to a better permeability for this kind of things. Very important, and that's where we stand for. We stand for green, green technology. And green technology also means that when you use green technology, we've been here with the help of some local people here, gathering material out of sea, grinding it, and we went to a new part. And that's what we've been doing together at Queen's. This is important as well. I've told the people from the local organization, from Microcentrum here, what's going to happen. From 2022, also in Belgium, we are going to set up an R&D center. And this is the building. I can show you that today as the first ones. It's a building with a height of 10 meters. On top will be the offices. And it's a community, it's an ecosystem where we are going to work together in new parts, new possibilities, new ideas, new products for the future, which can be made there already. And here you see the next picture, where you see the left-hand side, for instance, the robotics and so on. So ecosystem, together with quite some organizations, and I think it's very important to go over the border. This I've been explaining to all of you. This is the car. And if you look at the car, it means after the car, we can dream, of course. And dream, that means when we are ready to produce parts for car industry, when we are ready to produce parts for medical applications, we can make those cocooning areas in airplane industry fully automated in just 20 to 30 minutes. And that's where it's all dealing about. I think we are almost coming here to the end. And if there are some questions, I think this is the moment where we can come, if necessary, for quite some people. I know it's new, it's a new technology. It's up and running. We have, for your information, 34 systems globally installed. But I must say the focus also with the Netherlands and Belgium together, and let's join in the EU-regio as we've been doing with light vehicle. It's very important to come to the next steps.
Johan, very interesting. Very thank you for your inspiring presentation upon part of the future, at least. Talking in terms of the industrial part, do you see that robot molding in high volumes serial production also could play a role?
We have to take care. Very, very good and perfect question, because today we are on a cycle time of, let's say, 30 minutes. And what I can tell is, and that's very important, at the 30 minutes, we are down today to 20 minutes with some customers. It means not the high volumes. It means not the real car industry. It means tram, truck, buses, off-road. And that's why the focus is on. If we would go to the automotive, then we still have to go down with cycle time. But we have the luck that the CapEx is much lower. So it means at this moment for quite some companies a relief.
Yeah, there's good benefits in that. Serial is sometimes even less than a minute, so that's quite a challenge. Looking at the materials in the product, in terms of circularity, and of course the automotive industry also has to look at circularity in their products, meaning that as being small countries, Belgium, Netherlands, compared to the rest of the world, that we quite some innovation done. How do you see the aspect of circularity in terms of sustainable manufacturing and sustainable materials playing a role from the automotive industry, most of the time a front runner, but exploring to others, other industries?
We see that still as a challenge. And as we speak today, we are doing some tests with biopolymers. Okay, are we now in favor or not of biopolymers, that's another question, but I can tell you material which is coming today from sugar beets will be used in the car. That means the body part of that car can be fully recycled. We are going to reuse it, first of all, and if we bury that car after 30 years, there are back again sugar beets on top.
Yeah.
No, I don't, sorry.
Yeah. But it's a possibility.
No.
And it's a contribution to sustainable, to a greener society,
yes,
coming from the industry.
Yes, fully.
Well, thank you very much from my side. I have a small present to thank you. Oh, coming back inside.
Thank you.
There you go.
Thank you,
and
sir.
Of course, being one of the first, the new automotive roadmap, which will be shown for the audience again later on, how you can download them. Thank you very much.
Thanks for being here.
Yes, indeed. That was, thank you very much, Johan, for your insightful presentation, so to say. Indeed, the questions that had to be asked have been asked, I think. Perfect. And you will also be reachable via the contact details that will be shared in your presentation later on, or via the website, I believe, of AMS, that you will be able to find you. And here, of course, indeed, are your contact details if anyone wants to go further into this topic. For now, this means the last of the live presentations coming here from the Microcentrum venue in Veldhoven. This was but it does not mean that the day is over. Of course, as you just referred to already, you looked into the program. That's very good to hear. We will have a couple of presentations by our sponsors that you can select again via the B2 Match tool. Click on My Agenda and then go to the your selected viewings, or you will have meet and matches scheduled in your calendar. Again, there, if you're not able to participate, please alarm the person that you have a meeting with, because then the networking makes sense. I myself, actually, I'm going also into a meeting later on, so okay. Looking forward to that. Thank you again, Johan. Hope to see you in the upcoming editions of this Technology for Automotive, when actually your big new building is ready, where you are participating in. Then you will, of course, come and tell us all about it, right?
Okay, yes. Great. Thanks.
Thank you very much. And we will start now with the upcoming meet and matches. And I hope, of course, this will be the last that you'll see of us live. So I hope to see you next year, but then again in person. I think we can all agree on that, right?
Very well.
Good.
Thanks.